In this video of the solid modeling basics tutorial, we're going to take a look at the sketches that we created in the previous section, and we're going to turn those into some solids that we can then use to additionally define some features in this water pick head that we've been working on. So the first thing is that we made a sketch here that has a couple of areas that we can use. I'm going to quickly hide this body here because it's currently in our way. I'm going to be looking for these light blue areas that tell me that there's an area that we can use to create a feature. I'm going to select that area there. I want to rotate this area around this axis, so I'm also going to shift click this axis, and you can see that the contextual panel here shows up a bunch of options that we can use with just those two selections. I want to revolve this, and I just want to do 360 degree revolve. That's good there. The other thing I can do is I can bring back this body. So right now I'm trying to use this little ring that we created to cut an additional feature in this original body that we had. So I'm going to double click both of those bodies, and you can see that they're both selected in our items panel. I'm also going to do a subtraction. You can see that we have a minus and a plus here. I'd actually like to subtract this ring here from the larger body, so I'm just going to switch those around. I don't really care about keeping the original body, so I'm going to leave that as none, and then I'm going to click done here. So now I have a single body that has this cutout in it. I'm going to bring back my sketch here because it has some additional features that we care about, so I'm going to click that eyeball. That sketch is going to come back, and right now I'm going to try to create an area here that we can revolve as well. This is going to define the upper portion of our water pick. So right here, I'd actually like to make this a hollow area. So in our very first extrusion, what happened was that we created this solid disk, and I actually don't want that to be solid. So if I go back to the original sketch, I have a new circle that I placed in here that we can use to edit this original extrusion that we created. So I'm going to go to our extrusion 2, which is what created this original disk. And I'm going to go back into our profile. I'm going to click edit. And I'm just going to select this outer ring now. So this is the new section that we're creating based off that same extrusion. So we're just doing a quick edit with an additional sketch. And that's going to be the bottom ring of this upper portion. And that's going to help us create that solid component that has a hollow inside. So in order to create that hollow inside, I'm first going to define our wall thickness here. So I'm just going to hop into our sketch. I'm going to click on this edge here, and I can go to this offset edge loop here. I can also just type the letter O, and that gives us an option to offset this edge. So I'm going to do 1.5, good right there. The other thing I'm going to do here is finish off some areas here that we can use to revolve. So I'm just going to select a line, and I'm just going to add this in here. I'm going to also create a small edge right here. Helps us to define that. And then the other thing is I need to close off this area here. So I'm going to add an extra edge here. And I'm also going to turn this into a regular line. So now I have my blue areas I can work with. This edge here, I just want to constrain really quickly to be vertical. I'm going to bring this back down and touch it to that edge there. And that looks pretty good right there. From there, I can select my blue areas and be able to revolve them. So I'm going to select these here. I'm going to grab this little tiny area here. And I can select the revolve button here. At which point I need to also select an axis, and that looks pretty good. So everything connects well, and it is a solid. We're going to click check, and now we have a couple bodies here. What we can do is select the series of bodies here and do one boolean to connect them all together. So I'm going to select the bodies in the items panel. We get our union button that pops up. And I'm just going to connect all those together. So now that's one solid body that we can work with and do a couple of different operations. One of the things I'd like to do next is to insert an extruded hole. through this entire body. This is a water pick, so we need to have a hole for that water to come through. And so I'm just going to come to this top surface here, and I'm going to create a new sketch. I'd like to offset this outer edge here so that we get our hole to come all the way through. So I'm going to taper this down too, sort of thinking about how this might be manufactured. But I'm going to start off by offsetting this to maintain our wall thickness. We're going to keep this as 1 millimeter. That way we have a tiny orifice that comes through there. And from there, I'm going to select this area. And I'm going to create an extrusion. So I'm going to grab this arrow here. And I'm just going to pass it all the way through. And you can automatically see that it's creating a hole for us. And if I wanted to change that option, I could also select this little button here. And it gives us some options here. But right now, it's automatically selecting an extrusion for us. The other thing I'd like to do is to have this hole taper a little bit. Again, thinking through the manufacturing process, this would be injection molded or something like that. So I'm going to put this in the negative area here. I'm just going to give it a -1 degree. So there's a hole that tapers from that upper section that we had all the way down to the lower one. And that is a hole that passes all the way through at a 1 degree taper. And we can look at all those features again in this last extrusion. We can see that we're subtracting the end result. So that looks pretty good right there. So that finishes up with some basic solid modeling tools in Shapr3D. In the next video, we're going to take a look at using a sweep in order to finish off this design. We're also going to take a look at fillets and chamfers to help clean up this design a little bit. And then finally, we'll create a patterned revolve around the edge of this so that we can make a little grip for people to hold on to when they're using this tool.